everybody. Welcome to the Reflection Show. It is Thursday night and it's going down. That's right. Tonight I have one of these most amazing guys here in Orlando, Florida, Central Florida. You know, I'm your host, Ramsey Rizard, and it's always a pleasure to have you tune in right here on the Reflection Show. And I said it earlier, this guy, he means the world to me. Met him through a real great friend of mine, Will Price. But ever since we connected through a conversation, I said, you know what? People need to know what is happening here in Central Florida. And guess who it is that's going to give us a little background on the fairground right here in Central Florida? JP!
Brother, how
What's
are you
up,
today?
Jay? How you doing?
Always good, always good. Beautiful day here at the fairgrounds.
It is, it is. The fairground. Oh, I mean, it's here in Central Florida, JP. And there's people who's watching right now that have no idea what goes down here in Central Florida fairgrounds. Okay. JP, tell everyone, what do you do, your age, and how did you get connected with the fairgrounds?
Okay, my story is pretty simple. You know, I'm from Rhode Island, came out to Florida for school. I went to Full Sail University, studied entertainment business.
Yeah.
Always kind of had a passion for concerts.
Right.
Always knew I wanted to be involved in concerts. Didn't really know exactly what I wanted to do.
Right.
Wasn't sure whether it was production, management, helping with the artists. You know, I knew I just loved the live event.
Right.
So kind of came out to Florida, graduated, got a chance to work in the club scene. Did some of the biggest club shows in Orlando for about three, 4 years. Then ended up here at the fairgrounds. And my title here is the events manager. I'm 24 years old.
Wait, hold on. 24 years old.
Yep. Oh, yeah.
24 years old.
Yeah. Yep.
You done did the club life, managing, bringing positive, bringing heavy numbers into what you were doing.
1,500-person venue.
1,500-person venue.
Yep.
And here you are at the age of 24.
Yep.
Taking over 50,000 people.
Sometimes, yeah, for a big event like that, yeah. Oh, yeah. It's, you know, I sit back and look sometimes, and sometimes I'm very happy, sometimes I'm upset, but, you know, life's life, and you gotta deal the hand you're played.
Hold on, JP. You have ups and downs here?
Not here, in life in general.
That's what I'm saying.
I think we all have ups and downs, you know? Sometimes I feel stuck, or sometimes I feel like I'm not making the progress I want to make.
Yeah.
You know, and you look at the bright side, you look at the things you've done, and I've accomplished a lot, so, you know, I'm very happy.
But to other people, they would look at your success as a place of happiness.
Oh, yeah.
But for you, you're reflecting on the moment right now, and you're telling us that's watching this that you go through ups and downs, though you pack out, though you guys pack out an entire 90 acres of people at events.
Exactly. You know, some events are much easier than others, you know, and some promoters are way easier to deal with than other promoters. So, you know, you have those good events, you have those bad events, you know. Even something like the weather can play into a day of, you know, it was a great show or an awful show, you know.
Wow.
We deal with those factors here left and right.
So let's continue talking about your transition.
Okay.
From the club industry into, I would call this more of a corporate industry. How was that transition for you at the age of 24? And even though you accomplished so much, because there's a lot of millennials out there, there's a lot of people that are watching this, they believe that once they conquer one arena, they can come into another and conquer that too. But of course you dealt with challenges.
Yeah.
Tell us a little bit about your transition.
So to simply answer that, I'm still learning, you know? Going from the club world is a place where every night is a party. You know, it's not focusing on the overall picture, where here there's a lot of things you need to implement. You know, parking, security, staffing, the maintenance, the overnight cleanups, if we have a back-to-back event, things like that. Where the club was, open the doors, throw a party for 6 hours, close the doors, do it all over again.
Wow.
Where here, you know, we deal with Live Nation, we deal with AAG, you know, we have some big name companies that come in and expect a big name arena ready to go, ready to put on a show. And sometimes it's perfect, and other times, you know, we get here and we have to deal with the factors we're faced with.
Wow, JP, you're doing some boss moves.
Thank you, thank you.
I mean, to deal with huge names.
Yes.
To bring a different level of professionalism. What made you realize that you were able to handle this level of pressure?
You know, I'm a person where I always kind of just learn by doing.
Yeah.
You know, I like to get thrown into the fire, and I think here, like, my very first day here was Caribbean Festival 2 years ago, and that was about an 8,000-person event, and it was chaos. And, you know, my boss, Sean, he just literally dumped me on the stage and said, good luck. And, you know, it got a little ugly, but we made it through.
Right.
You know, I'm still here today. I made it through the second year of it. So, you know, it's being able to work on your feet, answer questions, do what needs to be done, and keeping a positive mindset. You know, like, I don't let a negative day affect me the next day, because the next day I might have an even bigger show that I need to be full ready just to get it done. You know,
let's talk about the positive aspect of working with a very positive leading staff.
Okay.
What is that like if when people come here to book a show? How does the staff support what you do, and how does the staff support what happens here at the fairground?
So first of all, Sean, the president here, he's awesome. He supports pretty much anything we want to do here. He sees kind of my vision, what I want to get done here. So to kind of have a boss that really supports you and wants to do what you want to do,
right,
like, makes it, like, I feel like I have a full hand, you know, like, I'm ready to go and just crush it.
Yeah.
You know, the maintenance staff, those guys, they love me, they respect me, they work awesome with me. If I need something done, I get with them, they bang it out, we move on to the next project. You know, it's about meeting deadlines and getting those things done, and simple as that. You know, if we have three shows this week, we need to make sure all three of those promoters are happy. You know, we need to make sure all the staff gets enough sleep, gets enough refueling, is ready to go for the next one, because sometimes we may start the week off with a tiny little 2,000 person show, but this week we're gonna end the week with two 20,000 person shows back to back. You know, and the staff needs to be ready, be able to handle that kind of stuff. And we have a pretty good team, you know, and we always continue to push forward.
Wow, always continue to push forward. Guys, we're gonna take a short commercial break, and when we come back, we're gonna talk about the impact that the Central Florida Fairgrounds have here in the community. And as you heard JP talk about earlier, the staff. What does it mean to be able to staff people here in a low-income area, which they would consider here in Orlando, Florida, Pine Hills? What does it mean for the staff to have something to look forward to when it comes to events here at the Central Florida Fairgrounds? Stay tuned. We got more coming your way.
Central Florida Fairground, located in the heart of Orlando. Over 100 events a year, with about 50 concerts, it brings the best of what Orlando presents. This is the place to enjoy time with family and friends. Central Florida Fairgrounds, we do more just for you.
Welcome back, guys, to the Reflection Show. Ramsey Rezard, you know I'm your number one host, and I thank you so much for tuning in. Earlier, we had JP, my man, right, is coming here to talk about the Central Florida Fairgrounds. And earlier, we was talking about the staff. We was talking about what the staff does here at the Central Florida Fairground and the positive effect that JP has the opportunity to experience. And JP, you know, a lot of people don't know what goes down at the Central Florida Fairgrounds. They pass by it like I used to do Will Price invited me and say, yo, Ramsey, you need to come check out what's happening here in your backyard.
Yep.
And when I came, man, I mean, I was just blown away with I mean, 90 acres.
There's
I didn't even know this was 90. This was 90 acres.
Yep. Oh yeah.
And then I see people working. I mean, I see a lot of things happening. Give me a little background on how the Central Florida Fairgrounds provide jobs for people in the low-income area.
Easy. You know, any given event, we're staffing security, maintenance, parking staff, all those kind of different positions, bar and concessions people. Security is one of the big ones. You know, on an amphitheater show for 10,000 people, we're going to have anywhere between 50 to 100 guards. You know, and those security guards are being pulled from different areas and different neighborhoods right here in Central Florida.
Yeah.
We do have a company called Laz Security and Parking. They handle all that. You know, PCI does our concessions, same kind of thing. They're hiring the local bartenders downtown who have the face, you know, can help promote the property,
right,
bring people out here. And then, you know, the same thing as the maintenance guys. We pull from Labor Hall, that different kind of opportunities that we give out constantly to different people in the neighborhood that need a place to work, need a place to kind of make some money to pay their rent that week. And here we have literally events that cater to 500 people to events that cater this weekend. We have Funk Fest, we'll do 20,000 a day.
Wow.
So, you know, and that takes a lot of people to put on that show.
And that's pretty cool, because when I think about all these events that's happening here in Pine Hills, not only do the people you have on staff get to benefit, but you're talking about gas stations.
Oh.
You're talking about
gas stations, the McDonald's,
Walmart.
When I leave here at 12
I mean, we ain't got
morning.
No Chick-fil-A. We had Chick-fil-A. Now, you know, I don't think anybody would be able to make it to Central Florida Fairgrounds.
I like it.
But I mean, yo, gas stations, small business, small businesses.
I'll leave here, you know, if we do one of our warehouse concerts, 3 a.m. and I'll drive by the Wawa, the McDonald's, and there's a line of cars there just trying to get some food and whatnot. And that's 3 a.m. on a Saturday night, where normally they're sitting there twiddling their thumbs that early in the morning, you know?
Right.
So we do bring different kind of influxes of people at different times throughout the year, you know? Obviously, some months are slower than others, but we get through and we bring the people out here.
Now, this is a million-dollar question, because, you know, even for myself, I've overlooked the Central Florida Fairground.
Okay.
You know, the only thing I've seen was the flea market in the front. And I'm like, well, I don't know what's really there. So if I'm not, if there's nothing for me to do there.
Understand.
There's no point of me being there. You understand what I'm saying? So why do people like myself overlook the Central Florida Fairground?
I just don't think they've ever really opened their eyes to the property. You know, the flea market's a great point. You know, you drive by on 50 and that's really all you see. You know, you see the flea market, which is open every Saturday and Sunday, and that's all you might be familiar with. You know, we have other people who come out here for our gun show, our Repticon shows, you know, different expo style events. We do a guitar show, and they may be familiar with the property only because of that event.
Right.
Or, you know, we do have people that come to our concerts, our expo events. They go to the flea market every week, and they're used to the whole flow of the property, and those are the people that are really amazed at what we can and can't do here, because they see us, you know, we'll have one Saturday where there's nothing but a flea market, and then the next Saturday, like this Saturday, we'll have 20,000 people out in the field for a big concert, you know, and to be able to go from point A to point B like that, some days it's literally a 2 to 3 day difference where we really only have the time to get ready for that event.
So that's why people really don't see
The transformation,
because everything, the turnover is so quick.
It has to be quick. You know, like last week we did Earth Day Birthday. We did about 14,000 people. This weekend we have Funk Fest. And in between all that, you know, we had a job fair. We had a bird show.
Yeah.
We had the flea market. Different small events like that we still have to cater to. It's a deal. It's a promoter that is looking for a place to do their business.
Yeah.
We still have to cater to those different smaller events while we're still trying to put on these huge festivals.
A huge festival. 90 acre property. Give me a picture of each section of this property.
Okay.
What goes down? I mean, right now we're in this beautiful amphitheater.
Yes.
Right?
Yep.
I mean, nobody really knows that it's by the lake. And right now we're actually recording this show right here in the amphitheater. It is beautiful. I mean, I'm not sweating, and you know, bald people like us, we sweat real quick.
I'm a big dude myself. I understand.
But you know, give me, paint a picture for those who are watching.
You know, I say we kind of have between 4 to 5 venues on the property. Okay. Obviously, the amphitheater, it's a 10,000 person standing room amphitheater.
Standing room?
Yeah, we don't have any seats here. We can bring seats in. Some events will bring in like the bottle service kind of VIP areas.
Yeah.
So, you know, we'll allow you to do that, but it is a standing room amphitheater. Mm. You know, some events, you can bring a blanket to sit out on the hill, things like that.
Yeah.
But it is a standing room amphitheater. The next venue we kind of have on property, which we're going to have some surprises for coming up, is our pavilion. We do have a pavilion that can fit about, I'd say, 5,000 to 6,000 people in it. Some really cool announcements coming for that later on. Really excited.
And you guys are lucky that JP is even giving you a little nugget on the Reflection Show, letting you what's coming down. Go ahead, JP. Give us some more DJ. Because you DJ JP right now. You mixing the right songs in this place.
I like it. One of the real reasons why, you know, the fairgrounds was an attraction for me was we have two expo hall warehouses. Mm. And I'm from the dance music world, and the old school rave in the warehouse is one of those things really making a comeback right now. And I kind of, when I got here, I really approached the discussion of, I really want to create this warehouse series.
Right.
Where we can bring in the hip hop guys, the EDM guys, and just give you an alternative venue where you're not used to just going to the same club week after week or the same concert hall every week to see the same guys, where, you know, you can come into one of our warehouses and literally create your experience. You know,
wow.
We have some guys that will do 3D mapping on the floors and the walls. We've had other events where they brought in 30 palm trees and created like a forest in the warehouse. And that's really where my heart lies, is that kind of old school, grungy concert.
But I like that though, JP, because you're talking about allowing people to use their creativity in a space to make it their own.
Exactly.
And because most venues, people have to go and they have to adjust.
You go to a club downtown, it is the same setup. You know, they might move a couch. You know, that's really, we're moving the whole building essentially.
Wow.
You know, we're moving
just,
tables,
just
chairs,
for that client.
You know. Exactly. You
just
know,
to cater to them.
Exactly. We need to know ahead of time, you know, if you come to me the day of the event and you need 100 things moved, I'm going to say, I only have a staff so big, we can only do so much.
Right.
But, you know, proper planning, the proper kind of timeline of events, so to bang all that kind of stuff out, you know, I call our commercial building an empty box. You know, you can literally do what you want to the building.
That's
good. Create that unique experience. Yeah. So every person that walks in the door is going to leave and be like, wow, that wasn't just another night downtown. That was a totally unique individual experience. You probably won't get anywhere else, to be honest with you.
No, I believe you. I mean, like I tell you, when Will brought me over here to the property and I was looking at this thing, I told Will, I said, yo, you can shoot movies out of these warehouses. I mean, green room, anything
you
want to do.
We've had people reach out about filming in the warehouses before. We've had a music video filmed right on this amphitheater we're sitting on right
now. Wow.
Here. Hell yeah.
So tell me more about the fields.
Okay.
Because it, 90 acres.
Yes.
Just, it looks like nothing happens here.
Yeah, exactly.
What happens in field A, field B? And I list it like that because I'm just, I like to put things in order.
Understand.
So tell me more about that.
So if you've ever come to a show for any of the expo events or the pavilion or even the amphitheater, you've parked in our field. The parking lot is our, also known as our festival field.
Okay.
So we transformed that, like this weekend with Funk Fest, we've transformed our parking lot into our festival grounds. We'll do between 20 to 25,000 people out there. We have an enormous stage that's been brought in. We'll have food trucks, all that kind of stuff out there.
Yeah.
Earth Day, birthday, they did helicopter rides, a wrestling match.
Yeah.
Just, you know, unique fun activations that make a space more than just a big grass field.
JP,
you know?
I don't think they heard you. 20 to how much?
20 to 25,000 is what
we're expecting. 25,000. This ain't no 2,000 people who's parking at Lake Eola to bring an awareness to something. This is 20 to 25,000 people from all over.
All over.
Coming to a place
that
people
Georgia.
Overlook.
Jacksonville, Georgia. I've had calls from people from Miami, literally all over.
Wow.
That are coming just for this one event, you know, and that's one event out of 365 days
and being right here, legendary individuals have come here to perform.
Oh yeah. Last year for Rare Orlando alone, Wiz Khalifa, Kodak Black, two of my, like, growing up as a kid, that's who I idolized, grew up listening to, and to be part of that show is amazing to me, you know?
Wow.
Like, those are literally some of the guys that my iPod is full, you know, and to see those guys, the rock legends, you know, we do the hip hop guys. We have a big hip hop show coming up. I'm very excited for. So
all here at the
right
Central
here.
Florida.
Literally right where we're
a place sitting. Where people do not realize that it has so much potential. All people need to do is to come by and see what's happening.
Even look at our website. You know, if you go to centralfloridafair.com, we post every single event on our calendar. And just scrolling through that event calendar, you're going to see the flea market. You're going to see all our expo events. You're going to see our amphitheater shows. And that's a wide variety of events. Like I said, an event from 200 to 500 people all the way up to a 20,000-person festival. You know?
Wow. So from the club industry to more of a corporate setting, to have to have 90 acres in the midst of your hands.
Yeah.
In the JP world, how does that make you feel to know that you are with a positive staff, right? And the direction is to build this community and to give back to this community because someone needs to not overlook it, but be a part of it. Yeah. How does that make you feel?
Oh, it makes me feel amazing. There's no other word for it.
No, you gotta say it. How does it make you feel?
Amazing.
How does it make you
amazing.
Feel? How does it make you feel?
Amazing. You know? So, it's just that one word. It's amazing to be here, you know? And like I say all the time, we'll do a small event, a big event, literally with like 1 or 2 days to flip it over. And that's a crazy change.
Yeah.
And that helps me develop. It helps me learn. It helps me get my gears turning to realize what it really takes to kind of attack an animal like this, you know?
Yeah, I mean, it is an animal. I mean, you got field A, you got field B, and then you got the flea market alone.
Yep.
And I remember me and Will was talking during the tour, and he was explaining to me the value of produce that is sold at that flea market.
Yep.
I mean, when people cannot afford to go to a Save-A-Lot or a Walmart, but they can come here and get organic, fresh produce and be able to have something healthy to eat.
Not even that.
That's powerful.
Restaurants are buying their food for the restaurants out there. Things like that, you know. You'll walk through the flea market, you'll see 1,000 different things for sale out there. You know, it's a very cool, unique spot. You know, the guitar expo that we do, that's another really cool thing. You know, we have guitar collectors from all across the world that come here just to show off their guitars and different things like that. Like I said, every day is a new event, and every day you're learning, you're seeing something else. It's just amazing.
Yeah. What do you guys believe here at Central Florida Fairgrounds? If there was a slogan, if there was a mission statement, or if there was a story, what would you say is a good positive reflection you would like to share with those watching?
Something like on to the next one. You know, every week there's a new event. Every week there's a new kind of genre of music coming in.
Yeah.
Every week there's a new expo event looking to rent our facility, and we have to be ready. We have to know exactly what those promoters need for each kind of event.
Right.
We have to be ready to, hey, we have to transform the property literally overnight, you know, things like that. So, you know, moving on, keeping events coming in, just constant change is really what I think our motto is. You know, we'll do Funk Fest this week, and then next week we have 2 amphitheater shows. I have an event where they're literally just parking buses in our fields.
Wow.
And then I have a dinner in one of my expo halls all next week, right after a 25,000-person
show.
All next week.
JP, before we end the show, I always say there's somebody that is just like JP.
Okay.
They're sitting behind that desk, and they might be a little discouraged.
Okay.
Because they have 90 acres to manage.
Yep.
Right? But they don't know the successful tools, or they don't have a successful positive staff to gear that JP in the right direction.
Okay.
As you look into the mirror and you reflect on where you were and where you are today, what is something positive that you can say to impact, influence, and inspire that person?
One thing that, like, in life in general, that helps me really be as successful as I am is being organized. Mm. Being able to track dates, being able to track times, being able to track meetings, that is key to me. And honestly, even if I'm looking for someone to bring onto my team, I don't want someone that has their mind in a million places. This is a world where you need A through Z. You know, you need to be able to understand
structure.
The projects ahead.
Yeah.
You need to be able to understand what you're looking at and be able to really answer questions do whatever you need to do real quick like that, you know? So organization, I think, is really one thing that anyone can really practice. Anyone can really become good at it. It might take you longer than the other person, but it's a really key piece to a big puzzle like this.
And one thing I do love about you, JP, just sitting here and getting to know you from last week, that you do have a heart to serve. You talked about it constantly through the conversation about serving your promoters, serving your sponsors, serving those clients, and serving the customers who's coming out here for every event. Because as you know, in this industry, we call it the hospitality industry.
Exactly.
If you don't have hospitality, then you don't have a house to build.
Exactly. Exactly.
Because ain't nobody going to come in if you're going to serve them nasty.
You know, the way I really look at it is any event can become a yearly event. And if the promoter takes a loss.
Wait, say that again. Any event
can become an annual event.
No, we got to say it again because someone is sitting down there thinking about that, what you just said. You're dropping nuggets, bro. I mean, any event can become
an annual event. It's as simple as, you know, making sure the right pieces were in motion to make sure the event was a successful event.
Yeah.
Making sure the promoter was happy with the establishment they rented. If a promoter comes here, has a horrible experience, that's really to blame me almost, you know? I mean, weather, things like that aren't to blame me, you know, but I got to make sure the promoter's happy they put on a successful event, that they want to come back here and do another event, because another event can lead to another event. Or even if that individual promoter doesn't do an event again here, he's going to recommend us to one of his promoter friends that's going to continue to bring more events out here, regardless if it's a concert, an expo event, a booth for the flea market, a big festival for the field, anything along that line of work.
You guys heard it best here on The Reflection Show, hanging out with JP here at the Central Florida Fairground in Orlando, Florida. And it has just been an amazing interview to just hear not only successful stories, but some of the challenges he's dealt with, and also the love that he has for this 90 acre of land filled with different opportunities, different events here in Central Florida that's providing jobs for people here in the Pine Hills area. Guys, I'm so elated to have you guys to continue to watch this show. And I also, as I always say before I end the show, is make sure you subscribe, you follow us on social media, In the Mirror on Facebook and Instagram, In the Mirror TV on YouTube channel. We want you to be connected and be a part of this journey, because with more stories like JP, with more places like the Central Florida Fairground, we want you to be a part. And JP, to have them be a part, or if they want to book an event, because someone could be watching this from California, New York, maybe Australia, how can they contact you guys?
The easiest way is through Facebook. It's JP Day, D-A-Y. Okay. Find me on Facebook, reach out. I talk to everybody. I'm a friend to everybody. Another good social to reach out to is the Orlando Amphitheater socials. Orlando Amphitheater on Facebook, on Instagram, and then of course my baby, the Orlando Warehouse Series. Yeah. That's on Instagram and Facebook, ready to go. You know, you'll be able to see a good list of our show concerts by following that.
Right.
And you know, my personal Facebook, if you ever have a question, reach out. You know, say you saw the video. I'm always happy to help a fellow industry friend.
And what's the website for the Central Florida Fairground?
CentralFloridaFair.com.
CentralFloridaFair.com. Guys, thank you so much for taking your time out on this Thursday evening to watch The Reflection Show. We always want to bring an experience that's going to change your life, because it's all about impacting, influencing, and inspiring you, because this platform was made just for you. This is Ramsey Rizard, The Reflection Show. Remember, your experience matters. Thank you for watching.
Wait on other people to be what you've been called to be. You can't wait on their affirmation.
To all my Facebook and Instagrammers, how you guys doing today? I'm so excited to be tuning in right here, right now, as you're watching this. I wanted to do a quick announcement. My show now, The Reflection Show, airs at 9 p.m. every Thursday. You ask for it, I'm giving it to you. So make sure you share, like, comment, and also don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel right down here, In the Mirror TV, on our YouTube channel. We want you to be a part of this journey. Thank you all so much for being a part of this journey. I'm so thankful for all of your support, and I definitely want you to subscribe to our YouTube channel. And remember, your experience matters.